Neutrons are useful for scientific research. Former Oak Ridge National Laboratory Director Thom Mason describes the spallation neutron source.
The spallation neutron source is an accelerator-based source of neutrons. Chadwick discovered the neutron in 1932. And so people were able to kind of study neutrons a little bit in the 30s with natural radioactive sources. But you can't get enough neutrons to really do anything useful from a natural source. You need to produce the neutrons somehow. And it became possible to produce neutrons in large quantities for the first time as a consequence of the Manhattan Project and the graphite reactor at Oak Ridge, or the X-10 pile, or the Clinton pile. It's sort of got various names that it's been called over the years. Was really the first example of a dedicated, purpose-built neutron source. And actually, with neutrons, one of their features is that you can see the light elements. They're much more sensitive to light elements, relatively speaking, than X-rays would be. So that makes neutrons useful if you want to figure out where the light elements are. So, for example, if you're trying to develop new drugs to treat disease and you want to understand how they work, often it's important to understand the proteins that those drugs may be interacting with. And those proteins typically have a kind of a backbone that's made up of heavier elements, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, but they also have a lot of hydrogen, and sometimes that hydrogen is really important for how those proteins work. And so you may use X-rays to figure out the backbone structure of a protein, and then you want to really understand how does it really work in the body and how is it that this potential drug might, you know, bolt onto it. And you can use neutrons to determine that, find out where those hydrogen atoms are that might be important for the functioning of that protein. I think one of the really interesting things about a facility like SNS or the sister facilities around the world is that it's got a very diverse user community. So you have people from my background, condensed matter physics, kind of invented the technique, if you will, but now it's used by chemists and biologists and materials scientists and engineers. There are also users from other national labs, both users from Oak Ridge, obviously, in the case of SNS, but actually all the DOE labs are trying to study materials for various purposes. At the moment, there's not a lot of classified research that goes on at the facilities because, as I said, it is more fundamental research. It's an interesting mix because you have all these different disciplines, people from all different sorts of institutions, often working together on the same projects. And because it's available internationally, you know, you have people coming from other countries because the facilities are really quite unique. So there are a lot of experiments that can really only be done at SNS, and so it attracts people from all over the world. It's about three-quarters academic, and the other 25% is industry and national lab.